I think it has to do with how the cultural system is organized in Egypt, which has a history. So basically, there is a dominant discourse that permeates, you know, not just the cultural field, but permeates many different branches, and this dominant discourse kind of is self-serving, basically, and it's politically so. It's about kind of creating a certain model and replicating variation from it. If you do not exactly fit that model, then their policy is to usually attempt to ignore you. The reason why I'm doing this now is because I didn't have any reasons not to do a show on this scale before, but except two things. One is that the infrastructure did not exist. I find it very important that the works are shown in a way that they do not get compromised. There is a relationship between the exhibition and Salt in here because they're both surveys, so they're not exhausted in any way. The Salt exhibition is larger than the one here, but it's not just about scale, it's about kind of giving a sense of the practice. I think that the angle is a bit different. So, for example, here I work with that story for the curator. And what that entails is that there is a conversation between me and her, and that conversation has something to do with, that's kind of her job, has something to do with how she's looking at this work, how she's understanding it, and what kind of angle she wants to approach. My practice is very multifaceted, so I work with a lot of mediums and a lot of approaches, and I've always done that. What I like about this show is that it's kind of divided into different spaces, and in a sense it's almost like several different exhibitions. For example, the space we're doing here is a bit more intimate. There's a lot of textual works, there's the relationship to the viewer is more one in which they kind of like look at something and slowly unravel it. While in the space next to us, which is a larger space, it plays with one mentality. I like this idea of modulation, in which the audience enters something. For example, they come here to this space first, and it is a certain exhibition, it has a certain sensibility, and it opens up things in a very specific fashion. And then they move into another space, and then everything kind of suddenly changes.
Work I showed was very close to the industry.
think more recent works, it's still taking time to understand what they are, because I myself don't always know what the work is, and with time I start understanding it in different ways. And so sometimes you finish something, you're incredibly excited by it, and then after some time it kind of fades away, and then after some more time it kind of comes back, and you start to understand it in a new way.
Back a bit more.
That looks to me straight. Actually, the table right behind you, which is a documentation table of 17 in the museum, is incredibly personal and close to me. Maybe the final work is not, which is a book, because I can't do that. But the project itself was, because I was the fuel of this project. What do I want most out of life? I mean, I'm going to say something very banal. I want to be happy.
Are you happy?
I'm happy. Yeah, happy, but I'm happy. But that's maybe that's wanting too much, because I'm already happy. That's something.